The Testament of Freedom by composer Randall Thompson, a setting of four passages from the writings of Thomas Jefferson for Men's Voices and Orchestra, performed by the National Symphony Orchestra under the distinguished baton of Howard Mitchell, with the voices of the Georgetown University Choir, Paul Hume, director. Howard Mitchell returns to the podium to accept the plaudits of the people here at Constitution Hall. He is nodding to the composer. Now he has turned and asked all the members of the National Symphony Orchestra to join him in accepting the applause of the audience here at Constitution Hall. And quite a night this has been. I must say that in this performance of the Testament of Freedom, the chorus of Howard University, Warner Lawson, director, was to have been in the vocal group, but because of the severity of the snowstorm that has all but paralyzed the traffic here in the Washington, Virginia area, the buses transporting the members of the chorus were unable to get through. And so, under this particular situation, Howard Mitchell and the orchestra and just the male voices from Georgetown University took part in this. It is now intermission time here at Constitution Hall, and time for us to pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Mutual Broadcasting System, a service to independent stations. As a public service, the Mutual Broadcasting System and its affiliated independent stations throughout the nation are presenting an exclusive radio broadcast of the official 1961 inaugural concert by the National Symphony Orchestra of Washington, D.C. The members of the National Symphony Orchestra are following their conductor, Howard Mitchell, from the stage in order to allow the changing of the decor of the stage. We are now making way for the performance of The Rhapsody in Blue by George Gershwin. Earl Wilde, pianist. From the time of his dazzling series of concerts at the age of 19 with the NBC Symphony Orchestra under Arturo Toscanini, pianist Earl Wilde has established a career as a champion of modern works. He was chosen to play the American premiere of American composer Paul Creston's piano concerto and Shostakovich's piano trio in E minor. Mr. Earl Wilde precedes our conductor to the stage. He's now taking a bow at the center of the platform, takes his place at the piano as our conductor, Howard Mitchell, takes his place upon the podium.